much as a million? Well, 1,000 times 1,000. Or perhaps you can better understand in these terms.
Here he goes. Look here. Oh, they make contact.
Contact. They go down into the corner side by side, and Jeff Gordon holds off the challenge. This is the last lap of the race, folks. They're on to the backstretch, and Gordon lengthens his lead just a little bit. He lengthens it out as Jeff Burton and Dale Jarrett drop back just a little bit. Here he comes off of the fourth corner. Jeff Burton will make a challenge off the corner onto the straightaway.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, we did
but
it.
Jeff Gordon wins it.
Holy cow.
If you were to be paid $1 million.
And the Brinks truck is running him down.
Saying, I got $1 million here for you, Jeff.
Hey, T. Wayne Robertson and Jeff Gordon in Brooklyn. Let's get over. Jeff, you are the man, the $1 million man. Congratulations.
Unbelievable. I should have never won that race, Jerry, but oh my goodness, good Lord was looking over us. Man, what a team. What a team, man. These guys were busting off some great pit stops. And if I hadn't been out front, I don't think we could have won it. But I want to thank God for the ability and just showing this team and myself never to give up, and that it could be our day, and it was. And
what about the last lap? They're stacking the money behind you, so you got plenty of time. They got a Megan to stack in behind you on the car. That final lap, you and Jeff Burton, it got awfully close.
You know, my car picked up a really, really bad push. I thought maybe I could hold them off for three laps, but all of a sudden when I come down and take the white flag, the right front just went away on me. I didn't know if I had a fender rubbing or what. And I saw him coming, and I blocked him. He hit me in the rear bumper, and I was just glad that I didn't spin. I kept it going, and that slowed his momentum down enough to where I could block him. I'm sure he's not happy, but Jeff, $1 million. Come on, buddy. What'd you expect me to do, man?
The man is Jeff Gordon. His mission is to add one more 500-mile race victory to his resume, which will mean a $1 million bonus. It'll be tough, but not impossible. It's been tried on four different occasions, but only accomplished once.
Jim Elliott is going for immortality. Jim Elliott has won an additional $1 million in 1985.
I'm genuine. I'm bona fide. Original, only one of a kind. I got too much hair, but none to spare. I'm a vision millionaire. Automatic, I'm in a one and a need. Automatic, I'm in a guarantee. Automatic, I got a speed guarantee. You want me automatically. I stood by, gave it a try. Told my man I wish I never had. And I had a weekend in with three best friends. All that a want and a need. Automatic, all that a want and a need. Automatic, all that a good guarantee. Automatic, I got a good guarantee.
He's already won over $2.5 million this season, and today could add another million. The 48th edition of the longest surviving race on NASCAR's oldest track takes on even more significance today as Jeff Gordon tries to become the second driver to win the Winston Million.
Who in this country hasn't dreamed that one day you would win the lottery? Who hasn't wished they would have just one chance to chase a million-dollar rainbow? Today, all eyes are focused on one man and his pursuit of the American dream. The task would seem simple for 26-year-old Jeff Gordon. If he is the first to finish 500 miles, then he will reap the riches. And Jeff, the questions millions want to know at home, what are your thoughts, and more importantly, what are your chances?
Well, you know, I feel really good. We've had a great weekend so far. It's been a lot of fun going for this million, but today's the true test, and we've been to Victory Lane here before in Darlington, and it's a tough, tough place to get there. But we do have that experience and hope that it pays off. Got a great team, and everybody's really doing a fantastic job so far, and
we can just stay out of trouble and be at the end. I think our chances are good.
Many say it's one man chasing one chance for one race for $1 million, but I beg to differ. It is not one man, as he said. It is one team, and the man who leads that team is standing by with Bill Weber.
And that would be Ray Evernham. Now, he turned 40 this week, but he hopes to turn a million here today. You idolize coaches like Vince Lombardi and Pat Riley, and you've told everyone how it could be $10 million, and these guys couldn't try any harder. So how have you prepared your team for this big event?
Same exact way we prepared last week at Bristol. Everybody's worked real well with us, trying to keep the pressure off the guys and letting us do our job. And, you know, when you come to Darlington, you can't force it here at this place. You know, you just got to kind of ride along with her and be in position at the end. And that's what we're going to do. You know, we're having fun with it. It's a great opportunity RJ Reynolds has given us to go for the million. But, you know, we're going to have fun with it, but we're going to run our race.
The last words you're going to say to your driver before we start.
Well, normally I don't talk to him until we get rolling around, but I'm going to tell him, like, this is what I just said to you and what we talked up about in the truck. You know, you can't force this place. You just got to ride it out because it always changes at the end.
Good luck.
Thank you very much.
That's Ray Evernham, and his Rainbow Warriors are ready for the 1997 Mountain Dew Southern 500 and the quest
for $1 million. For the most famous words in the world of motorsports, today's Grand Marshal, David Norman. Gentlemen, start your engines!
$1 million possible for Jeff Gordon. One of the closest point battles in history, plus a racetrack that these drivers have essentially never competed on. And while we're talking about potential winners, let me name a couple of more. Dale Earnhardt, a nine-time going to row number four. It's Jeff Gordon. Three missions today, the points, the million, and winning three straight. We've heard Ray Evernham and Jeff Gordon say that it's just another race. You prepare for this race just like you did last weekend at Bristol. But is it, Benny?
No, it's not. This is the Mountain Dew Southern 500.
And we will have an onboard camera with Jeff Gordon and a lot of extra coverage. The crowd is on its feet. Every seat is filled. The 48th Mountain Dew Southern 500 is under green. Trying to take over the sixth position from Ken Schrader and does so.
That was the car he was trying to pass in practice yesterday, and they almost wrecked, but he gets by and cleaned it this time. Hood up on his car, but there's nowhere to go when you hit an oil slick like that except into a wall or another car.
Well, this accident occurred. So Dale Earnhardt on pit road while Ray Evernham and the rest of the Rainbow Warriors are in good shape at the moment. Jeff running in the sixth position as the caution is over Darlington for the first time this afternoon in the Mountain Dew Southern 500. With movement here in the first 15 drivers, here is Jeff Gordon challenging Hutch Strickland for fifth.
Well, he challenged him all day long here last year for first.
It looked like last year's Mountain Dew Southern 500 for the lead late in the race. Hutch Strickland leading the race, and Jeff Gordon trying to take over the... And Jeff Gordon's going to get by Hutch Strickland and move in to that fifth spot.
There is Gordon with $1 million riding on this race here today. If he wins, he collects the Winston bonus.
Bob, I suspect he likes where he's at right now. Sort of sitting there, nobody close to him in front or behind. Got a good, clean racetrack to run on there. That's a good position to be in, right there for a while.
Jeff Gordon, who has a great talent for saving those tires, riding around there, saving those tires. And when everybody else's tire starts wearing and slowing down, his car maintains that same speed. Jerry Pine?
Yeah, that's exactly what Ray Evernham just said to Jeff Gordon. He said, Jeff, you got to think survival for 400 miles. All you want to do is survive for the first 400 miles, and then we'll go after him the final 100, but you're great exactly where you are.
Kyle Petty is in. Here's John Kernan.
And the great run that he had.
in the Busch race. Now, Mark Martin just got passed by Jeff Gordon as he continues his march toward the front. But the story on Burton is the fact that yesterday in happy hour, they had to chase this car a little bit. But the weather change from yesterday to today is considerable.
Welcome back to ESPN's live coverage of the Mountain Dew Southern 500 from Darlington Raceway in South Carolina. Jeff Gordon has taken over the third position. He's passed Bobby Labonte, who was passed by Dale Jarrett just a couple of laps ago while we were in break. So it's Elliott, Jarrett, Gordon, and Bobby Labonte.
Jeff Gordon was the fastest car of the top six.
Now we see that Gordon is within just two or three car lengths of Dale Jarrett. Advantage on Dale Jarrett.
Jeff Burton a moment ago, guys. He still continues to move towards the front. He has moved up to sixth.
And Jeff Burton that time was near the fastest car in the top six.
By quite a margin, as a matter of fact. He is almost 2 miles an hour faster than those running around him.
They're working on their 33rd lap right now. That's about halfway through a pit stop or what we expect to be somewhere between 60 and 70 laps. So that's a pretty good indication that his car is working well.
Going down from 154 down to 153 and no traffic. And Burton still over 156 miles per hour. So Jeff Burton, the X-side car, clearly right now the class of the top 10.
And rest assured, his spotter or pit crew are making him aware of that. They tell him, take care of those tires. And he says, I am. This thing feels so good.
So Jimmy Spencer was the second fastest lap.
Fourth spot, third spot. Jerry Bunches, Jeff got a problem?
Well, Benny, I think he does. He just radioed and said, hey, Ray, the car is loose. And Ray said, how bad is it? And Jeff said, Ray, it's all I can do to hang on. He said, the car has gotten really, really loose. Ray said, my friend, just back off. We'll get it fixed. He's just got to back off now and try to hang on to it.
So the Rainbow Warriors may have some work cut out for themselves here to get that car back handling right.
We saw Jeff coming off the fourth quarter. He come down start finish line, and the line he was taking indicated
maybe on his way to duplicating what he did here in 1985, winning the race. But only Jeff Gordon eligible for the Winston Million here this afternoon. And there is Jeff Gordon, who is in fourth position at the moment, a little over 4 seconds behind the leader.
There's your second, third, and fourth place cars.
Second, Dale Jarrett in third, and Jeff Gordon in fourth. I would say that Jeff Gordon has more going for him than the rest of them, but that's not the case, because the object is to win the race.
You know, he's been complaining about how the car is loose on him, and we, as an added bonus to our coverage here in the Mountain Dew Southern 500, have Ray Evernham, his crew chief, and Jeff Gordon mic so that we can hear the conversations between those two people to see if Jeff can get indeed the $1 million bonus. The NASCAR spotlight now is in reference to the NFL and the NHL spotlights that we have. Let's listen to that conversation.
All right, bud, you're running a pretty good clip there. Is the looseness all the way through or just exit?
Pretty much all the way through.
Four.
Of the 99 inside, we're behind. I'm doing all I can right now to hang on to it.
Four. Be smooth, do the best you can. When we table, just tighten up, bud.
Doing okay, man. Pit stops will be 10 to 15 laps. Have me look at your temperatures again when you get a chance.
Is that Ray Evernham cool or what?
Boy, he is.
Calm. He said, we're okay. I mean, you're a little loose. When you come in, we'll fix the thing. give the driver all the confidence in the world that it will be fixed.
And those pit stops will be coming up here pretty soon, I think, Benny. Several cars have already pitted, including Bobby Labonte coming into the pits right now, Sterling Marlin.
As Jeff Gordon heads on the pit road.
They felt like they couldn't wait any longer. He had to come in, get those four tires on, make that chassis adjustment. Now they're just praying. No caution flag for the next few laps till all the other cars make their pit stop.
Here's Jerry.
Jeff Gordon's Rainbow Warriors go to work, and they put the handle in the right rear. They're going to work on the track bar and try to tighten the car up. You heard Jeff Gordon say to Ray Abraham, I'm doing all I can do to hang on. Great pit stop on the right side. They clean the grill. Jeff has just reported the water temperature was really getting up. Watch them brush the grill. 18.2 seconds. Great pit stop. That's the kind of stuff that can win you $1 million.
Wow, just outstanding work by the Rainbow Warriors as Gordon goes back out onto the racetrack.
That's something we haven't mentioned. That's right, because the last time by, Jeff Burton ran 151.5 miles per hour. The sixth place car, Jeff Gordon, ran 159 miles per hour. So that's how much time he's losing while he stays out there with those four tires. Oh, spun out.
And with the sequence of pit stops, Jeff Gordon is the leader of the race, and he has almost a three-second advantage on Dale Jarrett. And that 18.2 second pit stop by the Warriors contributed to his lead.
And Jeff Burton, the guy that was leading before last time by, he was 8.5 seconds behind Jeff Gordon.
Now his pit stop was not that much slower. He stayed out on the racetrack what 5 or 6 laps longer than did Jeff Gordon. And Jeff Gordon with those new tires on was running at least a second of a lap faster than Jeff Gordon. And so that lady put some distance there. Now when we get near the end of the run, the green flag run, that'll probably even itself out.
So the man going for the Winston Million, $1 million in bonus money, has taken the lead in the Mountain Dew Southern 500 after 74 laps. Back in a moment. 77 laps completed out of 367 at the Mountain Dew Southern 500, and Jeff Gordon is the leader as he comes up on the 36th car of Derek Cope to try to put him a lap down. Cope is in 19th position. Look at this graphic, an AutoZone off-track interval. This will include the lap before, the pit stop, and the lap after.
Man, look at that, Nick. Jeff Gordon beat Jeff Burton by 4.5 seconds on the time he came to the start-finish line, made the pit stop, came back to the start-finish line. That's a lot.
And probably one of those seconds would have been in the difference in the lap speed around there, as we pointed out a moment ago, with Jeff Burton having the old tires and Jeff Gordon having the new ones. But that still was a big difference.
You got to get slowed down to 55 miles an hour by the time you hit the mark, or you'll be penalized by NASCAR. Gordon up alongside Gary Cope now. And earlier this week here at Darlington, Ernie Irvin was...
This is a special exception here today.
Gordon now coming up on that car that gave him some problems during happy hour yesterday.
Today, because this Kenny Schrader and the stroll car will go a lap down if the 24 cars are passing. So we know that this Schrader does not want that 24 car to go by. But can he stop it? Doesn't look like it.
No, don't think he can.
And Schrader's running at 18th position, so now 17 cars are on the lead lap, and the next one to go down would be Jeff Bodine. Gordon just passed Ken Schrader to put him a lap down, and let's take a look at what I mentioned just a few minutes ago, and that is the problem that Jeff and Kenny had during happy hour yesterday.
Watch as they come off turn two. They're just practicing, but Gordon gets the car about 30 degrees sideways, touches the left rear tire on Schrader's car. Schrader, meanwhile, brushed the wall when they came off the corner. It was just 6 inches from disaster for both those cars.
Could have been a $1 million moment right there, but everything came out okay, and now Jeff Gordon is leading the race. On board with him. Now here is Jeff Bodine being lapped now as Gordon goes to the inside in the corner.
17th position, Jeff Bodine goes a lap down.
Well, obviously they got the problem corrected on Jeff Gordon's pit stop, huh?
It looks like they do have the car in pretty good shape. And, you know, Jeff Burton, the guy who just dominated the first segment. Right now, he's gaining a little bit on Jeff Gordon, but not as fast as we thought he would with those fresh tires. He now is a little less than five.
The 96 car of Todd Bodine and the 2 car is also being shown out of the race. That, of course, is Rusty Wallace. There's Jeff Gordon. And the Mountain Dew Southern 500 continuing here with him leading by a second over Dale Jarrett. Completed here at Darlington Raceway in South Carolina, and Jeff Gordon leads the Mountain Dew Southern 500. Join ESPN tomorrow night at 7:30 Eastern for NFL Prime Monday. 90 minutes of the most informative news, results, and injury reports from week one of the NFL season. And then, all right, Jeff Gordon is leading. We heard his conversation with Ray Evernham before his pit stop. Jeff was complaining that the car was loose. Now, let's also check the conversation between these two guys after the pit stop and see if there was any improvement in the way this car is handling. This in our NASCAR Spotlight.
4,200, got it, Dave. Nice and easy, guys. Four tires, one in the panner. Four tires, one in the panner. Okay, it's going to start a little tighter now, but I'll burn the right rear off trying to get her to turn. All right, we got the water back down to 200 and 240. Therefore, bud, the grill screens are clogging up. That's all it is. The grill screens are clogging. Be real easy on them tires, Jeff. You're leading the race. You're the leader right now. Be easy on them tires.
That's pit road speed in water, second gear. That would be 55 miles per hour. One in the panel bar. That's one down on the rear sway bar. And what else, Ned, did he say?
Well, he said temperature of the water was 205, I believe, and then he said 240. That didn't mean that the water was going from 205 to 240. That was the oil temperature that was at 240.
Jeff Gordon, second in the point standings coming in here. He has had great races. 16 finishes in the top five, including 8 wins. But on the other hand, he has had some very bad races. As a matter of fact, 6 finishes outside the top five, and all of them have been 21st or worst, and included in those 2 DNFs. The leader, Jeff Gordon, continues to work traffic out there.
It was by Lance Hooper as he come off turn 2 in the 88 car. Dale Jarrett had just a few car lengths behind last time by, 3/4 of a second behind. Jeff Burton has closed into about 3 1/4 seconds.
And Sterling Marlin does pick his car too.
Gordon has led 32, still in the lead. Another Napa field.
And what a break for Ernie Irvin and Bobby Labonte. They were just about to go a lap down. Jeff Gordon was right on their bumper. Now they'll get to come all the way around the racetrack. Make that up.
Make up a 1.38 on the leader by 8 of a caution flag. What a big throw.
While we were in commercial break, let's take a look at what happened.
The Jeff Gordon coming in the pits. 88 car on Dale Jarrett. Also the 99 of Jeff Burton. I'm sure all these cars will change. 4 tires. Jeff Burton's car going around to the left side. Meanwhile, Dale Jarrett's team going around the left side. Also Jeff Gordon's team. Left side's up on Burton. Pit stop is finished. Once again, some trouble on the rear tire. Dale Jarrett is moving. Jeff Gordon is moving.
And Jeff was pitted farther down towards turn 1. As a result, he beat him out.
And Bill Elliott will come out in second spot. Gary Punch.
All right, the car number 24. They have clocked that pit stop, guys, at 17.2 seconds. It was 18.2 the last stop before they put an extra round in the Panhard bar. And the most important thing Ray said to Jeff was, Ray, Jeff, stay put. We have got to get that grill clean. Watch the water temperature. By the way, they're going to bring the 28 car back down pit road and hold him a lap as we check in with Bill Weber. Jerry Gale, Jarrett is...
Just as you rejoin us, the green flag comes out. We're back to racing at the Mountain Dew Southern 500 on lap 115. We had 6 laps of caution, and now back up front is Jeff Gordon.
Third Let's see if Bill Elliott can get that speed that he had early on in the race as he tried to chase down Jeff Gordon. He's working on him.
Yeah, he is.
There's 12 cars on the lead lap.
$2 million drivers right here. Bill won it in 85, and Gordon wants to win it this year.
Did he call Jeff Gordon? Didn't want to risk anything there. He just said, okay, you've got him. We'll let him pass. I'm fighting.
He knows that patience is the key.
That's right. He can lose a few battles right now as long as he wins the war. That's what he's here for.
Here. Now the skies have become partly sunny, but the temperature is high and so is the humidity.
But it wouldn't be Darlington in September.
We have completed 141 laps of this race, and Jeff Gordon, going for the Winston Million, is still very much in contention. He's running in fifth position at the moment. Jeff Burton and Ted Musgrave running side to side. They're the Roush teammates as Burton goes by Musgrave, and so does Jeff Gordon.
So move Jeff Gordon up to the fourth spot.
Jerry can update us now on the pit stops. Jerry?
Well, a lot of guys coming in the pits. I'm not going to talk about pit stops exactly, guys. What I was going to comment on is the fact that during these pit stops, a lot of drivers, you'd be surprised how fast word spreads. The drivers heard that Dale Earnhardt was not responsive to the crew during the parade lap and hit the wall in lap one. And then, very uncharacteristically, was taken out of the race car in an ambulance and taken away. So many drivers during that last caution were asking their crew chiefs, how is Dale Earnhardt? Please find out how Dale Earnhardt is. Even though he beat him like a drum for many years as a Winston Cup champion after champion, a lot of these guys, they're concerned about this race. But during the caution, when they could wander a little bit, they were very concerned about their colleague, Dale Earnhardt. Speaking of the Earnhardt and Childress team, let's check in over there with John Kernel.
And I'm with Dale Earnhardt's teammate Mike Skinner. Just had that very hard crash out there on the racetrack. He's been checked out in the infield care center. He is okay. Mike, that had to be a very scary ride. Just listening to it on my headset, it sounded scary to me.
I can't hear you. The problem with Jeff Gordon is almost identical. Gordon just radioed Ray Evernham and said, hey, Ray, remember how loose you were at the beginning of the race? And Ray said, yeah. He said, well, we're even worse now, and it's getting worse lap by lap. Ray said, it's because you're burning your right rear tire off trying to stay up with those four.
Well, he's led 44 laps here this afternoon. Has been one of six leaders. Jeff Gordon is 168.
You see Jeff Gordon going by. Jeff Gordon that then was about almost 13 seconds behind the leaders. More than a half lap. Not quite a half lap, I should say.
And so it will allow Jeff and everybody else who is having some handling problems to come in and get them corrected.
Let's take a look.
And Jeff Gordon is going to take a rubber out of the left front as the 88 car is out. Here's a 24 pulling out in front of his teammate, the 5 of Terry Lottie, 88 behind him. And
back in just a moment. All right, Jeff Gordon now is being shown in second position right behind the leader, Bill Elliott. Now, we've been eavesdropping on the conversation between Jeff and Ray Evernham and other members of the crew as to whether or not they've been making the right adjustments as we go along here. Let's listen to the most recent conversation in another NASCAR Spotlight.
Take a look at those last two sets. I know you already have. Are we wearing the right rear out the worst?
I believe they're not yet. The left sides are wearing worse.
Let me ask you a question. Do you think that we made it too tight and then it was getting loose? Did we go too far in that pattern and maybe we should have went with some wedge instead? I don't know, Ray. Maybe. Did it feel tighter and then get looser up off? No, not yet. I don't know what's going on over here. The right rear is dumb. I'm real loose. What is Dick Trickle doing?
Can I ask him to move out of the way? He's not racing us. Just hold this up.
I was just wondering if everybody else is complaining loose or was it just us and then set of tires?
might have been that set of tires. Mark's complaining loose, but most of the other Fords are complaining tight.
That goes to show you that they monitor the other teams to find out what they're doing. They listen to their radio broadcast to find out what they're doing. And when Ray Evernham said, "Tap, tell him to move over, he's not racing us," that's Dave Tapman, the spotter for the 24 car up on top of the roof here.
Down to Bill Weber with more pit updates.
Okay, well, the Kellogg's crew is the reigning Unical pit crew champions. They just ripped one off.
And Gordon goes up the hill, trickle those new tires. But we've seen those cars come off the corner with momentum. Can Jeff Gordon do it? Yes, he does.
Well.
Now Jarrett looks to the inside of Terry Labonte, but falls back behind him. You know, we talked to Jeff Gordon in a Speed Week interview that aired Friday night, and one of the things that he mentioned on a couple of occasions, he said that he and Ray are communicating about this race, and I think what we have heard from the car spotlight bears that out. They have a lot of conversation together and work through their problems through communication.
Lake Speed, the 9 car closes up a little.
If points were awarded right now, Jeff Gordon would have a 24-point margin.
Our pit stall is going to be very, very wet, and we are pitting right beside Jeff Gordon, so when he comes down pit road, he can hit our water and slide through his pits. NASCAR says, no, you got to stay put, so they're trying to dry the pit. They've been on and off pit road with sweepers and blowers, trying to dry the moisture up, but it's still pretty doggone wet down here in the Haviland pit.
As the field comes down the main straightaway, Jeff Gordon is still second, and Dale Jarrett is in third as he tries to get around Dick Trickle.
Here comes Gordon on the inside of speed. Trying to get on the inside. Can't quite make it. This looks to be where Jeff Gordon really having a good race car through this first and second corner, but not good enough that time to get by lead speed.
You're looking at these 5 laps on the green to get the big rate halfway point.
The first car not on the lead lap. He's in 12th spot, and here is Gordon now getting around Lake Speed.
And Dale Jarrett is not going to take all that time to get around Lake Speed, which will be a huge advantage.
11 cars on the lead lap, and Dick Trickle is in 12th position.
Let's take a look at the speeds again.
And we see that Elliott, 161. With no traffic in front of him, Jimmy Spencer back in traffic, ran 160 miles.
And last lap, Jeff Gordon was the fastest. And was again. And now both Jeff Gordon and Dale Jarrett begin to close in on the leader, Bill Elliott. The interval is down to less than a half second.
And look at that fourth place car back there. Jeff Burton is coming in there, too. I think he's gained on all of them.
Bill Elliott, the leader at the halfway point of this race. 7 of the 22 races have been won by the driver running up front at the halfway point. John Kernan is with Lance Hoover. Jeff Gordon is the fastest car among the top 6 right now. Let's show you another Napa field summary. He's closing in on Bill, isn't he?
He's getting closer and closer. He's just a third of a second behind.
And Benny pointed out there a moment ago, he really gets off turn 2 over there. That is a good spot on the racetrack for him. And as you well know, in driving this track for a number of years, that's a good spot to have a car working good for you. You can get through pointing down 3 and 4 down there. You can sort of wrestle the car through there. But you get through pointing down 1 and 2 over there is the key to getting around this racetrack.
Been able to put a few car lengths on Dale Jarrett as he tries to catch Bill Elliott.
There you see it came off turn 2, moved in a little bit closer.
Once again, that last lap, Jeff had the fastest speed. Jeff Gordon has 4 top 5s and 5 top 10s in 9 races here, including 3 wins, not only going for the Winston Million today, but trying to become the first driver to win 3 consecutive Southern 500s.
Zip right back.
now. Those four cars seem to be straight lines.
Mark Martin has just picked up another position. Coming up now.
He's been making a lot of adjustments on his Valvoline Ford today.
Points leader coming in, and lead changes. Six cautions for 37 laps. The average speed, close to 120 miles an hour. Those who have picked up five bonus points were leading the race. Bill Elliott has led the most. Also, Gordon, Burton, Musgrave, Waltrip, and Bobby
Jeff
LeBeau.
Gordon, it slowed there all of a sudden.
Ned, you're exactly right. Just a moment ago, they radioed and told Bill Elliott, hey, don't worry about the 24 cars. About now, he's going to start getting loose. And about that time, Jeff Gordon told Ray Everham, it is really getting loose in racing. You know what it is? It's that right rear tire we're heating up. That's why it's going to be hard to hang on, particularly down in turns one and two.
So just like clockwork, huh? It goes away.
Well, when that right rear tire heats up, it'll make her loose.
Check the speeds at the line. Remember, about 10 laps ago, he was the fastest for several consecutive laps.
And that might be why that he got loose on him.
And you can see he slowed down almost 2 miles per hour slower than the leader, and 2.5 miles per hour slower than Dale Jarrett and Jeff Burton.
Might have been putting a little bit too much on that right rear tire, keeping up there and running those fast speeds. Bill Elliott smooth out there. He's taking care of those tires.
Well, we were interrupted there for good reason with our Busch race recap, so let's go back to it and check a car that is off of the track behind the wall with the work being done on it. And here is a list of the drivers and cars that have officially dropped out of competition. Those five plus these five. So that's the situation. Jeff Gordon still very much in the hunt, although he's lost a few positions here recently.
Track looks clear over there. That's a little bit better. I still think we'd be tighter. You want to wait a little bit, though, not give up all the track position right now? Unless Elliott comes in, right? You only run three laps, bud. You're doing good. We'll keep working on that thing, trying to get it better. I mean, no, right now we need to rubber it. That's what we're going to end up having to do with it, Jeff. But you're doing good. The main thing you got to do is keep that thing out of position so it don't get in trouble.
And Ray Everham telling Jeff Gordon, you're doing a great job. Keep calm. Keep collected. We'll have a caution flag in just a moment, and we'll adjust on this thing, and it needs the rubber. I don't know which spring, but it needs rubber. And guess what, folks?
The caution just came out.
Don't you love it when plans come together?
Meanwhile, the car number 24, Jeff Gordon, Ray Everham said we're going to take a partial rubber out of the right front and put a full rubber in. They have the right front tire off to DuPont Chevrolet. They're taking a partial rubber out, putting a full rubber in. 94 cars down on the way, the 6 car down on the way, the 24 car still sitting off pit road. They finally get the rubber in, and now the right front tire back on. They will pull the jack and come around to the left side. Bill Gordon is down and away.
So he gives up a lot of track position out there, but the main thing is to get the car handling.
Well, now there are only 10 cars on the lead lap, Bob, so it won't hurt it nearly as bad as it would if there were a lot more cars on the lead lap.
And if he waited another to the next pit stop, right, and then to make that change, then he'd have to fight to do, he wouldn't have that many laps to fight his way back through. So I think that was very wise to do it now so that he still has about 150 laps to fight his way back to the front.
Watching him go down the back stretch and into the third turn.
I'm sure he'll come back in, change those left sides.
Yep. Yes, indeed, he is. Ray looks toward turn number four and sees Jeff coming off the racetrack and down pit road once again to get the left change. Jerry?
And of course they had warned Jeff that there might be some moisture in the 28th pit. With this heat, that moisture has been long gone and dried up. Now they have made the adjustment on the right front with the partial rubber out and the full rubber in. It will bring the DuPont Chevrolet back down pit road for a left side tire. Jack going underneath that big dollar sign just right below the, right above the jack stop. Left front tire, left rear tire on. He puts it in gear and pulls away.
Well, as he goes out now. He'll be in 10th place. But, Bob, we talked about having a lot of time, guys. Look at that.
That's behind us, and I couldn't see it, but, boy.
He might not have as much time as we thought if that cloud comes over the racetrack. That looks mean.
The 48th running of the Mountain Dew Southern 500.
Long. Jeff Gordon is back in eighth position now after that lengthy pit stop.
Right now, I think the car is trying to push a little bit. After putting that rubber in the right front, I think the car is trying to push a little bit more than he's used to the substitute. It'll take him a lap or two to get acclimated to the new suspension.
Jeff Burton tries to get by at late speed.
Traffic is at 160 and a half.
Jeff Gordon has called Mark Martin. 1 leader, the guy in second place, number 6 in the points that are going in this race. And here goes Jeff Gordon, right by Mark Martin.
He sees those dark clouds back behind the main grandstand and turns 1 and 2. To the front as quickly as possible.
And that time, Jeff Burton was the fastest car, a little bit faster than the front two. Here comes Gordon, diving to the inside of Kenny Schrader.
It seems like those cars have run together a lot this weekend. Schrader moves up and lets Gordon in. Martin go by. Kenny Wallace, he's running there in that group. He's only a lap down in 12th position. Not a bad run for Kenny, who was the pole sitter at Bristol last week. We have an AutoZone on-track interval here, laps 217 to 221, showing the interval between the leader, Elliott, and 7th place, Jeff Gordon, and it's expanding.
Well, it's getting larger because Gordon is caught back in traffic. Elliott has nothing in front of him except racing. Jeff Gordon has to try to fight his way through, just like Ted Musgrave, trying to pass Musgrave going down in turn one. Can't quite do it.
Musgrave is in 6th position. Gordon is in 7th.
Michael Walton right in front of this group.
And then if that cloud cover comes over, which is already moving in down to turn 1 and 2, that's going to tighten the racetrack up. And the move that Ray Evernham made might not work in their favor. If the racetrack gets cooler, if the temperatures gets cooler, then they'll tighten the racetrack up and maybe hurt him a little bit. Now he's moved into 6th place.
Just past Ted Musgrave, going into 6th. Right ahead of him is Michael Walton, who's in 5th position.
Michael Walton looks back at Jeff Gordon as he closes in right on the back bumper. Jeff Gordon, folks, he's been under a rock. Is going for $1 million bonus if he can win this race.
Down to Jerry Punch in the Jeff Gordon pit.
Ray, you made an adjustment on the car, which apparently has made the car better, but the weather is moving in. Do you have enough time?
Car's not good enough. I got a feeling the weather's going to go by us, so we'll see. We're going to have to work on the car just a little bit more. We need to make another couple stops, Jerry. Hopefully we'll get it.
You know, it's a special day. You want to win the million, but you also got a special assistant crew chief here today.
That's right. Andrew Jackson on the pit box. He was the inspiration for a 10,000-person bone marrow drive in Fayetteville, North Carolina. And, you know, we're real proud to have him on board here with us, and hopefully it'll inspire a lot more people. You know, I want people to see those people that are waiting for bone marrow transplants are not statistics. Their names and faces, just like Andrew. And Andrew's waiting for a bone marrow transplant.
That is 14-year-old Andrew Jackson. You're looking at it right there. And what an exhibit of courage he is. 10,000 people signed up in Fayetteville because of this young man's courage. He has the exact same leukemia as afflicted Rick Hendricks, CML, chronic myelogenous leukemia. This young man hopes to someday have a bone marrow match and maybe be a professional baseball player. But we got to tell you, folks, they are in desperate need of minorities to step forward and be
bone marrow donors.
Barry Bonds, the baseball player for the San Francisco Giants, is making a plea for African Americans to go out and be a bone marrow donor because he has a young man that mirrors Andrew Jackson. A young man, 14, 15 years old, wants to be a baseball player. Barry Bonds met him, fell in love with him. He went down, became a donor, and he's urging all African Americans to go by to go, hey, folks, I met Andrew Jackson. Trust me.
And Jeff Gordon continues to come to the front. He's about to take fourth place from Terry Labonte, his teammate. And for the past few laps, his has been the fastest car on the racetrack.
And maybe we said that maybe that adjustment wouldn't work. The racetrack in its entirety now is under a cloud cover. Maybe that is helping them. Maybe they didn't get as much as they needed to tighten it up, and the clouds are helping them. Who knows? It looks like it's running good.
He's got a lot of racetrack, though, between himself and his next opponent, which would be the third-place car of Jeff Burton. In fact, there's almost a little over 8 seconds.
We'll see this time by if Jeff Gordon is able to run as fast as a leader. Just about as fast as the leader in the race. He had lost a little momentum as he passed Labonte off the corner, so this should be a good indication of how fast his car is versus those three Fords up front. Oh, he's drifting in high. This time by, we see the 94 car, 156, 134. That time he was the second fastest to Bill Elliott, but Elliott, the leader, was a little bit quicker.
He's about 8.7 tenths seconds behind Bill Elliott, and Jeff Gordon is. Check and see if he's picked up any of that this time by.
Once again, Elliott faster than the other two cars. Here comes Gordon, but he's in traffic, so that will slow his car down. You can see, just catching cars in a wrong spot, and you can see he lost 2 miles per hour.
Now, however, he has some clean racetrack ahead of him, a lot of it, as a matter of fact.
Burton, he's going to take one round out of the right rear. Gordon's car now down and away as we see lightning flashing off of turn one.
And so the weather continues to move in on pit road. Jeff Gordon moved up a position ahead of the 99.
And every car on the lead lap stopped. Stopped at something, especially Ricky Rudd, the last car to lead lap, might have stayed out there in case it rained and the race not restart. But every car stopped.
We are under caution because Kenny Wallace got up into the wall.
Million-dollar man Jeff Gordon back on pit road. They're going to pull the full rubber out of the right front and put a half a rubber back in. They've also put a half a round out of the right rear. And a moment ago, they came in and took the left rear tire off and pulled the pin to disconnect the rear sway bar. They're trying to make adjustments, so Gordon has at least a shot to try to somehow catch Elliott. The car now down off the jacks as he moves back down pit road. Weather is happening here. A lot of people talking about, there's the full rubber they just took out of the right front. They put a half a rubber back in. And, of course, they have made some serious adjustments. A lot of concern, though, over weather. Will the rain move in? Can Jeff Gordon have enough to catch the lead and pick up a million? We'll find out in a moment.
Well, there have been several drivers who have won two Southern 500s in a row, including Jeff Gordon. And now Jeff today, in addition to going for the $1 million bonus, goes for his third straight Southern 500. Right now, he's back in 10th position. And here comes Jeff Gordon, who has passed Ted Musgrave and gone into 8th spot. So he's picked up two since we went green.
Almost 2 seconds behind the leader. Apparently this set of tires that he's got on now is not working as well, and I would predict since the clouds over has come over that maybe his car has gotten a little tight.
There goes Jeff Gordon, the inside of the 8 car driven by Hutt Strickland, which is 2 laps down in 19th. Hutt was, however, in the lead lap for a long time. He's having another good run here at Darlington, not nearly as good as he has had in the past.
Involved in the spin out then in turn one, I believe, earlier today. Someone got into someone. someone else, and there was a couple cars burned, I think.
Well, just a moment ago, Ray Evernham called Jeff Gordon, said, Jeff, don't worry about the tires. Weather is coming. Run as hard as you can run it, partner.
And Jeff Gordon just gets by Mark Martin. So moves him into the seventh spot.
Four, the 88, 99, and 24 on your screen. Dale Jarrett and Jeff Burton are both happy with their car. They will simply take four tires and fuel, then head back out onto the racetrack. Weather is threatening. Pit stops going quickly. Jerry Bunch.
And they really want to get Jeff Gordon out in a hurry. Four tires, one can of fuel. Here's the 88 down pit road, 21, 24, 17.5 seconds. And the 24 car just does miss Phil Elliott as he's pulling out of his pit.
Wow. And look at Michael Walker, the Zitco car.
Great pit stop for the Wood Brothers. Got out in second place.
In a couple of pit stops ago, we documented that Jeff Gordon still was having handling problems, and there was a lot of question marks and a lot of decisions to be made. This is how they reached their decision as we take a look again at a NASCAR spotlight.
Still, that right rear, or at least the rear tire, just do not want to grip coming off too.
Four, I'm with you, bud. Just keep doing the best you can, please. We got some more adjustments if we get a chance to make them.
Some loosens down at one and two, like right in the middle. But, I mean, I would like to take some of that front spring rubber out of it if we could, do something in the rear.
Close up. Let's go. We're going to pull the left rear wheel off and pull the pin on the sway bar. Pull the pin on the sway bar. He's coming off pit road. Pull the left rear off, pull the pin on the sway bar.
I was already closed up. You should have called me a lot earlier.
He's closed up. We're going to pull that full out. We're going to put a half back in. I want to take one round out of the right rear. Andy, have you got somebody to do that one round out of the right rear? Okay. You're go up behind the 10 car. We're back behind all lead lap cars. Ain't no big deal.
Well, they keep working. I admire these guys. They keep working and working and working, trying to make that car as fast as anybody there. Bill Weber?
And another team that's been working hard today, especially on pit road, the Citgo crew. Michael Waltrip has had some excellent pit stops. One that was 18.10, but the last two, 17.41, and this most recent one, 17.22. Now, his car is better after they run 10 laps. Green about to come out. Watch the 21 car behind DJ.
And then Jeff Gordon lined up. Position. Green flag comes out on lap 279. Michael Waltrip trying to get back on track. He has posted seven straight finishes of 22nd or more. And if the points were awarded right now, look at the tightness. Jeff Gordon with a 15-point margin on Mark Martin as they would change positions. And here comes, looks like Jeff Gordon had a notion there. Side of Michael Waltrip coming down the front straightaway.
Michael Waltrip is on a very high line through the corner, leaving it open for Jeff Gordon. He's going to take advantage of it and take that second spot. And the crowd is up in arms, cheering, and I guess what I'm doing, Ray, it's all the same difference to him, right?
Now Jeff Gordon moves to second position and is about a half second away from Dale Jarrett as the drama continues here at Darlington.
Was he close to that wall up in 3 and 4 or what? Elliott goes by Michael Walton, goes into third.
It's Labor Day weekend in Darlington, South Carolina, and Jeff Gordon, who is running second in the race, is going for $1 million here this afternoon. And the CART PPG Championship is up for grabs in the Molson Indy Vancouver. That's coming up next here on ESPN after the conclusion of the coverage of our event. Jeff Gordon now at about 7/10 of a second behind Dale Jarrett.
He's been gaining on Dale Jarrett. That time by, Dale Jarrett gained just a little bit on Jeff Gordon.
Exactly. For the last five laps, they've averaged out about the same.
Let's take a look at the interval leaderboard, and we'll show you who the fastest is on the racetrack.
Jeff Gordon.
Yep.
A little bit faster than Dale Jarrett. And also the 99 car. About the same speed, just a little bit slower than
Gordon had the fastest lap at over 161 miles an hour. Here is Jeff Burton coming up on Bill Elliott. Elliott, by the way, has clinched the 5 bonus points for leading the most laps here today. He led 180.
Once again, Jeff Gordon faster than Dale Jarrett. But Jeff Gordon, folks, if he can keep it off the wall, he'll be okay. He is using every inch of the right foot. How close he comes to that wall, in the middle of the corner. He's right up against that wall.
There you see that Gordon is still the fastest car, indicated by the yellow number one, and he is a half second behind Dale Jarrett. And there is Jeff Burton taking over third spot from Bill Elliott.
Watch Jeff Gordon as he goes in the corner, lets the car drift right up against the wall, right against that wall. Now it come back off.
Gives him a good run off the turn. But at that time, Jarrett was the fastest.
Yeah. And watch Jarrett as he goes, and watch Gordon as he goes up right against the wall in the middle of the corner.
He's trying to find a spot. Just, you know, within 6 inches of what he's been running, that might let him go just a little bit faster.
He's searching for a faster way around this racetrack. Something he has, and look at Jarrett that time. He goes high, Gordon up high. All these guys trying to find, as you said, Ned, that magic spot that lets him pick up 1/10 of a second per lap.
Well, he's 3/4 of a second back now.
Well, as Benny said, he's driving his heart out, and he's certainly been using those tires up.
$1 million will go to Jeff Gordon. If he can win here today, he will win 3 of the 4 races in the NASCAR schedule. And there are reports of raindrops falling on the racetrack. See a little bit of moisture on the windshield, just a little bit there at the bottom. That time, Jeff Gordon had the fastest lap. Jarrett was second and Burton third, and that allowed Jeff to close in just a little bit. So we'll continue to track the activity here at Darlington with 75 laps to go. Jeff Gordon still in the hunt for the Winston Million, but he's second to Dale Jarrett at the moment. We're under caution once again here at Darlington, this time because of rain. Not a great deal, but enough to bring out the caution flag. And quite frankly, everybody was quite surprised when those on the lead lap came in for pit stops. Coming out with the lead, Jeff Gordon.
Yeah, I was totally surprised that they would come in because the caution is for weather.
See? Ray Evernham talking to his driver, telling him, here's the caution flag, there's a pace car, pit road is open. Here comes Gordon. Dale Jarrett stays on the racetrack, and then all of a sudden, he turns left.
Well, he was not going to stop, and boy, that cost him a lot right there. He was fortunate to be able to come back out in second place.
So everybody moved down to his assigned pit. The crews went to work, and here's how it went.
And we, in the middle is Bill Elliott. Elliott is working on something on the right rear. We see Jarrett gets his pit stop complete about the same time Jeff Gordon completes. But Bill Elliott will go back to 8th spot. He spent a lot of time working on something in the right rear.
And he has come back in the pits since then, but he has to go back out. He's back in, John. Let's go to the pits. John Kernan.
Ned, they're putting tape on the grill. It also looks like something, a piece of...
Well, what a time for the Rainbow Warriors to pull off their second best stop of the day. Jeff Gordon's crew, led by that man right there, Ray Evernham, 17.66 seconds, 4 tires, and 1 round in the right rear, and they have been celebrating here ever since, jumping up and down, high-fiving, smiling. You'd think they just might have won $1 million. How about it, Bill Weber?
Well, Jerry, that entrance to pit road was unorthodox because Dale Jarrett was going to stay out. They told him to stay out, and he said, but everybody else.
Wow. So Jeff Gordon comes out with the lead now as we await the return of racing, but right now we're under caution due to rain. All kinds of things at stake today on this Labor Day weekend. Jeff Gordon has $1 million at stake. Alex Zanardi has a CART PPG title at stake. And the PPG Molson Indy Vancouver will be up right after We conclude the Mountain Dew Southern 500 that sees million-dollar Jeff Gordon in the lead right now. Boy, I tell you, they have worked and worked and worked on this race car, and we have heard a lot of the conversation between Jeff and Ray and everybody else, and they've got him in the lead, but he got it during pit stops. When the green comes out, we're going to see if he can maintain that lead, because Dale Jarrett has been strong today, so has Jeff Burton, Terry Labonte, Mark Martin, and a lot of others. Stay with us. More from Darlington in a moment.
If you ever watch a Jeff Gordon pit stop, wondering whether they're putting the wedge in or out of the car, it's a very simple way to figure it out. They've got color-coded wrenches. Now, this ivory-colored wrench, ivory starts with an I. They use this ivory-colored or white one for in. They use the orange one, which starts with an O. Orange is out. So the orange means they're taking wedge out. The ivory one, they're putting wedge in. So if they have a wrench over the wall and a crew member in a fluster of trying to get things done forgets which way he's going, he realizes, hey, I got ivory. I must be putting wedge in the car. He'll turn it in the right direction.
Boy, how about that? Yeah. Good job, Doc.
And, ladies and gentlemen, evidently whatever rain was in the area is gone because the signal is going out. Yep. One more lap before the green flag.
Lights went out on top of the pace car. We didn't have very much rain at all, just a few sprinkles, but it was enough to bring out the caution. But now we are set to go back to competition with Jeff Gordon in the lead, and there will be about 65 laps to go when the green comes out.
Which they could make it from here on a pit stop as far as...
Boy, those tires, will they be slipping and sliding at the end of these 65 laps?
You're right about that.
Gordon is the leader. Ray Evernham and the Rainbow Warriors have guided him throughout the afternoon into the front spot. Dale Jarrett and Terry Labonte are going to be lined up right behind him. Then Mark Martin and Jeff Burton.
Ricky Rudd is still in the lead lap in sixth. Michael Waltrip, seventh. Bobby Labonte, eighth. And Bill Elliott, ninth. Those are the nine cars that are on the lead lap.
Running in tenth position, the car up there beside Jeff Gordon is Jeff Bodine.
Start up that tight.
Car of Derek Coke is in the 11th position.
Okay.
Green, green, green. Green, green.
And Dale Jarrett is wasting no time trying to get to the inside of Jeff Gordon, but he didn't do it there in turn number two. They go down the back. Maintaining the advantage coming out of corner number four, but Jarrett looks to the inside. Nope, Gordon will lead. Well, Dale Jarrett knows how it feels to be in contention for $1 million and losing it. He did last year. And there are no give-me's here. Every man for himself.
Trust me, if he wins $1 million today, Jeff Gordon, he and his entire team will have worked for it.
You're right. But don't forget, there is something even more valuable coming up in December, and that is the NASCAR Winston Cup Championship. It will actually be decided by November and paid off at the NASCAR Winston Cup Banquet, which we will televise for you again here on ESPN. That pays the champion $1.5 million.
Jeff Burton is passing his teammate Mark Martin, who will take over the fourth position.
Terry Labonte continuing to run third. And the interval grows a little bit between first and second. It was 0.2 seconds. Now it's up to 3.
We saw that the last time. Those fresh green tires, the 24 car is very fast. And then after about 10 laps, the 88 car starts coming on. Once again, Jeff Gordon is using the racetrack up.
They got to be thinking, maybe, that this race will go green the rest of the way. And they got to save those tires as much as they can.
Here are the nine cars on the lead lap. Jeff Bodine running in 10th position. Straighter's 11th. Then Cope. Brad Bodine having a good run, and Dick Trickle isn't doing bad either after a great performance at Bristol last weekend.
Gordon right up against that fence.
Still the fastest car out there is Jeff Burton. Burton in car number 99. His lap speeds are faster, but he's
back of Jeff Gordon.
Hey, somebody said there's some smoke.
Jerry Punch, what's the deal?
Jeff just said last lap, he brushed the wall. He brushed the wall, and he asked the spotter, said, next time by, see if I got something rubbing over there. He just yelled wall, that's all he said, with the right rear. And that fender is very, very close in the right rear.
You're right. He has, you can see the damage on the right side of the Quad Chevrolet. And through those turns, that thing's smoking, and boy.
Dale Jarrett was faster that lap than Jeff Gordon, but the fastest of all.
He was using every inch of the racetrack. You see Everham talk about the car.
Now, does it rub enough that it might cut a tire? That's a big concern. You still got that championship to think about.
Well, we've seen some smoke coming from the right side of that car. Didn't see any that lap, but I think it's pretty definite that it is rubbing. Jerry?
What you just saw Ray Everham tell his driver was that the spotters are saying you're getting a little bit of rub through turns 3 and 4. Otherwise, it looks to be okay. We're going to keep a watch on it, and we'll keep you posted, Jeffrey. You're doing a great job.
In any case, Dale Jarrett is closing in. That lead that was 0.4 seconds for Jeff Gordon is now down to 0.2 seconds.
And Jeff Burton is closing in on both of them. He was about 2.5 seconds behind. He's only 1.8 behind now.
Wow, right against that fence. That wall doesn't scare that boy, does it?
I'm telling you. At the replay.
That's coming off the turn two.
That was more than a brush, that was a hit.
Yep.
Now we see Burton closing in.
I'm telling you, the kid is trying so hard to stay in front.
He's on it for the moment, too. He knows what this is all about. It's $1 million, but it's not much. The million, it's a trophy on the mantle case.
Gordon for the win here in the Mountain Dew Southern 500. We might mention that if Jeff Gordon wins the $1 million, if he wins this race, he will also go back into the point lead and would win another $30,000.
As for the Winston bonus, Winston gets up $10,000 in every race, and if a driver wins the race and is the points leader, he collects that and rolls over from one race to the other. So what you're saying is this is the third race since it was won.
Yep. Points leader is back in fifth position.
Slowly getting closer and closer.
But Benny, I think he's having to be very careful not to overuse those tires, because I think this race stands a good chance of going green the rest of the way. And if it does, those tires are going to be worn out. They're going to be slipping and sliding, and whoever takes care of his tires the best is going to be in the best position at the end of the race. Now Jeff Burton is closing in. He's just a little over a second behind. And when we started this, he was almost 3 seconds behind.
Well, while we watch this battle, you got a shot of Joe Nemeth in the backstretch. Joe has been nominated for second quarter NMPA Spirit Award. And while we're speaking of the NMPA, there were three drivers inducted into the Hall of Fame last night. They were Jack Ingram, Buddy Baker, and the late Neil Bonnet. And our congratulations to those drivers and their families on their induction into the Hall of Fame. And of course, Ned and Benny are both members of that Hall of Fame.
Yeah, that's a great affair, and it's certainly a good organization and a real honor to be an NMPA member. And also, we learned last night, our condolences to Winston, also a member of the National Motorsports Press Association Hall of Fame. His son passed away yesterday morning. Raymond, however, did make the banquet last night.
Boy, Jeff Burton is really closing in, isn't he?
Oh, yeah. Since he got close enough here for Florida, he sniffed that lead there, and he's moving in fast.
What Jeff Gordon needs is he needs for the 99 and 88 to race for about the next 30 laps and use their tires up while he sits out in front and cruises.
And Todd Perrin is wiping sweat, the crew chief for Dale Jarrett. Ray Evernham, pretty cool. He's been cool all afternoon.
Yep, I think you're right, Ben. That happens.
In the last 14 races, Jeff Burton has scored 10 top tens.
Wow.
He's fifth in points coming in.
Gordon and Jarrett have been catching them, and he's still maintaining a good pace.
40 laps to go. Coming up after we finish with being second today. All those drivers trying to prevent Alex from winning the title so that it can go to their next race at Laguna Seca.
First three cars, 4/10 of a second between the first three. Jeff Gordon, you're right along with Dale Jarrett in the Ford Quality Gear car. And Jeff Burton is third.
Last lap, the fastest car was Jeff Burton, but by just a wink of an eye.
Bob, I still haven't been impressed. Maybe none of them have shown their hand. Jeff Burton has shown his hand in running them down, but maybe he's sitting there cooling those tires now. And I had a feeling that Jarrett was doing that all along, but who knows? Jeff Gordon might be doing the same thing. As long as they're not pressured for the lead, will he just sit there and take it and not abuse his tires either?
And 7 leaders, 9 lead changes here south. Bill Elliott has led the most laps and has led 3 different times. Jeff has led 2 different times. The same interval between, or among all three of them, I should say. Just about a car length now. Jeff Gordon's career here at Darlington, in the first 5 races, he had 1 top 10 finish, but in the last 4, he's had 4 top 5s, including 3 wins. And we have a crash in turn 4.
Yeah, I think Burton does get by, but he had to really go high to do it.
Whoa. A heart-stopping moment for Gordon, Jarrett, and Burton.
A probably a heart-stopping for Ward Burton and any of them, as he was sitting there in the middle of the racetrack with the leaders bearing down on you.
Yeah. So now, what happens, guys?
Nope.
You see pit stops? Okay.
get on some new tires.
I believe they will come in. I believe they will change tires. And who will win the race off pit road? The winner off pit road might be the winner of the race. Here they come.
This is the 11th caution of the afternoon, and indeed, the first three, four, five, the cars on the lead lap are coming in. Bill Weber.
Dale Jarrett had told his crew his car is better than he was showing. Maybe just a tick tight, but he thinks he could have gotten by Jeff Gordon. Right now, all the leaders on pit road. Jarrett, the 2488-99 on your screen. Jarrett getting right side tires. Will get fuel. Burton is also in getting the right side tires. Gordon in his pit as well. They swing around to the left side on these cars. Jerry Punch. Four tires only for Jeff Gordon. They pull the right rear fender out. No fuel in the car. Dale Jarrett in the middle getting left side tires. Jeff Gordon at the bottom of your screen. Jarrett is rolling. Gordon fills the gap. Now Gordon is down and away. The 99 car finally down as they will all head back to turn one in the same order they came in.
Well, as far as those first two are concerned, Jeff Burton, I believe, lost a little bit off that because Terry Labonte beat him out.
Yeah, he lost about three or four positions.
Yeah, he really did.
Yeah, Terry Labonte beat him out. So did Ricky Rudd, Mark Martin.
Bill Elliott beat him out of the pit.
Bill Elliott, yep. Well, the Rainbow Warriors are huddling now and discussing the strategy here in the late going. Okay, let's go back to turn number four here a few laps ago and watch this incident involving Ward Burton and the leaders.
And they're just driving into a cloud of smoke. They all turn left because they don't see any smoke down there and barely get by Ward Burton. Wow.
From another angle.
You see there, Dale Jarrett slows down, almost gets hit in the back by Jeff Burton as he apparently saw what was happening up there, and he slowed down. And he and Jeff Gordon go to the left, and Jeff Burton stays back there and goes high.
Let's ride along with Jeff Gordon and see what he sees, which is about nothing.
Wow, he saw absolutely nothing.
Wow.
A heart-stopping moment here in the late stages of the Mountain Dew Southern 500. Remember, coming up next, the PPG Kart Race, the Molson Indy Vancouver. We were supposed to be off the air at this time, but we got a few more laps to run. The PPG Kart Race is coming up at the conclusion of our telecast. Stay with us. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Mountain Dew Southern 500 here at Darlington Raceway in South Carolina, and we're about to go back to green. We will next time around. Here's the situation. 336 of 367 laps have been completed, and we are about to go back to green with Jeff Gordon, the leader of the race, followed by Dale Jarrett, Terry Labonte, Ricky Rudd, Mark Martin, Bill Elliott, Jeff Burton, Michael Waltrip, and Bobby Labonte, those nine cars on the lead lap.
The concern, I think, that Jeff Gordon and that crew has now, they did not work on the right rear quarter panel, the right rear fender that we saw smoking when he brushed the wall earlier. Well, now he has those new tires on. He's going to be really going in that corner, putting the extreme pressure on that tire. The car will go down. The body will drift down. It may rub that right rear tire. We'll have to check and see.
Rick Henry, Jeff Gordon's car owner, is watching from his home in Charlotte fighting leukemia. But Rick is able to talk to the drivers and the crews, but he hasn't said a thing all day until just now. As Jeff left pit road, Rick got on the radio and said, I believe, Jeff, that we can do it.
As they made, they didn't have time to pull that fender off. But they know that as they run a few laps, as we discussed earlier,
that's what will perhaps get away.
Looks to me like that Jeff Gordon is stretching it out just a little bit.
This is what happens every time that Jeff Gordon jumps out for those first four or five laps. And then after that, they run about the same. And then the 88 car starts gaining back. But we talked about two car lengths being a big lead, Bob. Is that what you're talking about?
That's right. It is. It has been for the last few minutes. It's a huge lead. There is the interval between first and second.
He's stretching it out now, Bob. I think he's got a 2.5 car length advantage.
It's growing.
But what Jeff Gordon would like to do is keep Dale Jarrett from moving right up on his bumper and making his Chevrolet loose. So that 2 or 2.5 car lengths looms large.
24 laps to go. The field summary is in. Ken Schrader with
the two other cars on the racetrack becomes almost impossible to do.
These drivers have been out here for over 4 hours. You know they're getting tired, but they got to muster up enough strength to complete this thing. Gain as much as they can.
When they come around, there'll be 22 laps to go. Here's Jerry Punch.
Well, the most valuable bottle in the Gordon pit is not fuel, it is antacid. This little bottle of Rolaids being passed around among the Rainbow Warriors. You think there isn't pressure down here at Crest, knowing that within a little over 20 laps, they may have a shot at $1 million? They're thinking about it and talking about it.
And Dale Jarrett now mounts a charge and comes up right on the back bumper of the 24 car of Jeff Gordon.
That's what he wants to do. He wants to move up as close as he can to try to loosen the back end of that Chevrolet up.
Continues to run well.
The cloud cover came over. Bill's car just doesn't seem to have worked as well as it did. But when that sun was shining, he was tough.
Jarrett in an entire different room down in 3 and 4, running the bottom of the racetrack. Jeff Gordon running high all the way around. Goes in low. Let's that DuPont Chevy drift up right against the wall. He'll keep it up there. Now he'll turn left and bring it down off turn two.
Right there's his strength coming off that turn two. You see how much he picked up coming off that turn? The Chevrolet is turning good there and accelerating good on that turn.
Todd and Brad Barrett talking to left. Brad Barrett and brother on the right. Watching TD, I guess.
Jeff Gordon, key member of that team. And look at this, 13 and a half laps to go.
Wow.
Wow. Getting down to it. $1 million is hanging out there waiting for Jeff Gordon to claim it. But it's miles away right now.
Andrew Jackson, assistant crew chief today, watches Jeff Gordon go by. Young man looking for a bone marrow donor. Has leukemia.
Nice looking young man.
Jeff Burton, and you can make three.
Folks, don't go away. We've got 10 laps to go. Then we'll take you to Vancouver shortly thereafter for the Park PPG race. But this man, Jeff Gordon, has $1 million on the line. The Winston Million has only been won once, back in 1985 by Bill Elliott. The very first year it was offered.
All right. Dale Jarrett did. He's going to give his all right now.
Yeah,
he's 10 to go. He's going to go.
Yep, it's time to go. Now you don't save those tires any longer. If you got anything left, you gotta put it on. Jeff Gordon might be saying the same thing. Okay, it's 10 left to go. I gotta go, because Jeff Burton still continues to gain on him.
Within a second of Jeff Gordon.
Wow.
Interval to less than a second. 83 hundredths that last time around.
Jimmy Spencer, Gordon might have to check up a little bit. No, he didn't.
Spencer got out of the way, which was a gentlemanly thing to do.
Traffic is going to really be a problem.
And here comes Jeff Gordon to challenge Dale Jarrett, and that's maybe what Jeff Gordon needs.
Well, Walker getting the black flag, but he's staying down out of the way.
Traffic could play a hand, and who wins this thing?
Yeah, there's some going into turn three now as they come off of turn four. They'll catch them before this race is over.
The Bolson Indy Vancouver Kart PPG race coming up next here on ESPN. The title on the line there.
Red line moves over, lets the three cars go by. Do not impede their progress whatsoever. Boy, Jeff Burton, what a run he has had today.
Oh, man.
Come from far back a number of times. Ooh, Gordon slipped a little bit off the turn that time. Jarrett runs right up on him.
And Gordon slides up high on the racetrack again. Let's see what Dale Jarrett does here. Coming off the fourth corner onto the straightaway. No movement. But now there are five laps to go. Five to go with the Southern 500. Gordon is the leader and will win $1 million if he wins it.
Oh, Jarrett slipped a little bit that time.
But Jeff Gordon is having a little bit of trouble coming right as he comes off of turn two. Before, that was his strong point. Now it seems to be a weak point for him. But as long as those others behind him slip a little bit, we won't hurt him too bad.
Four to go.
Trump is Folks, I tell you, there's nobody in Darlington sitting down.
And I'll bet there are millions of race fans out there standing in their living rooms right now waiting to see if Gordon is indeed going to do it.
Jeff Burton sitting there saying, boy, if I could get by that 88 car, I could catch him. I know I could. Go, they run him down.
Here he comes. Burton to the inside of the yard. He's got a run off the corner.
But for that 36, no, it won't spoil his effort. Jared will have to back off and let Burton go.
Jeff Burton now goes into second position. There are less than three laps to go, but the interval now that Jeff Gordon has, the lead that he has grown just a little bit.
Yeah, that pass led him to pick up about five car lengths there.
The crowd looks on. Two laps to go.
I don't believe he can catch him and pass him. He might catch him, but I don't believe he can pass him. Boy, he's gained though. He picked up a bunch that time coming off at turn two.
Looks like Jeff Gordon had to get off the throttle that time off two for some reason.
And Burton closes in. How much is a million? Well, 1,000 times 1,000. Or perhaps you can better understand in these terms.
Here he goes. Look here. Oh, they make contact.
Contact. They go down into the corner side by side, and Jeff Gordon holds off the challenge. This is the last lap of the race, folks. They're on to the backstretch, and Gordon lengthens his lead just a little bit. He lengthens it out as Jeff Burton and Dale Jarrett drop back just a little bit. Here he comes off of the fourth corner. Jeff Burton will make a challenge off the corner onto the straightaway. If you were to be paid $1 million, Jack Kernan,
Ray Abraham, you guys refused to lose, and you guys won $1 million.
Yeah, you know, that just shows this team. I'm very fortunate to be part of it. I want to thank God because we had an awful lot of help today, and, you know, I don't know what to say. I'm stunned. I'm very fortunate to be part of this team. These guys work hard. They work together. They make great suggestions. You know, certainly, you know, it's something that we can look back on. Jeff Gordon's a great driver, but this is a great, great race team.
And not only the Winston Million bonus, but the only driver to win three straight Mountain Dew 7500s.
That was Rick Hendrick. Did you hear Rick Hendrick tell him?
Yep.
Good job.
If you were repeating $1 for every hour you're alive, you would have to live more than 114 years to accumulate $1 million. And although those achievements can't be measured by numbers alone, today numbers are important.
Jeff doesn't know where victory lane is.
For only the second time in 12 years, a milestone reached. Jeff Gordon adds another accomplishment to his already impressive record. He captures three of NASCAR's four crown jewel events in 1997 and wins the Winston Million. In just 147 starts, he has moved from eighth to sixth on the all-time earnings list and could become NASCAR's first $6 million man in 1997.
He's not happy, is he? Let me get out of his car. Somebody bring his car out. Let me go down and high-five everybody.
Wow.
And our coverage documented, I think, quite well how he and Ray and everybody else worked and worked and worked throughout the race. Finally got it right, and he won it.
And the Brinks truck is running him down.
Saying, I got $1 million here for you, Jeff.
Well, that's an awesome feat.
There's the Brinks truck and all the money. Running him down.
There it goes.
Oh, throwing the money up in the air. That's right.
Wow. Quite a moment for young Jeff Gordon, who has had so many emotional moments during the years. But this certainly has to be another one. Right at the top of the list. A Daytona 500 win, a Brickyard 400 win, three Southern 500 wins, a NASCAR Winston Cup championship. The crew heads to victory lane. That's where the check to Jeff Gordon will be presented. There's Brooke.
And still throwing money out the truck.
Well, that last lap was something, wasn't it?
Tell you what, if we don't hurry up and get the victory lane, we're going to throw $100,000 out of the way.
Yes, it is. This is a moment in racing history right here. The car has made it to victory lane.
They've been wanting to pay out that moving ball.
Yeah. A great day for Jeff Gordon, for NASCAR, for all the fans gathered here in South Carolina. And Jeff Gordon is back in the points lead also over Mark Martin by 25. Drive-through winner circle interview with Dr. Jerry Punch.
Hey, Dwayne Robertson and Jeff Gordon in Brooklyn. Let's get over. Jeff, you are the man, the million-dollar man. Congratulations.
Unbelievable. I should have never won that race, Jerry, but oh, my goodness. Good Lord was looking over us. Man, what a team. What a team, man. These guys were busting off some great pit stops. And if I hadn't been out front, I don't think we could have won it. But I want to thank God for the ability and just showing this team and myself never to give up and that it could be our day, and it was. And I want to thank DuPont Automotive Finishes and Chevrolet. What a great car. Goodyear tires, boy, they hung in there for us. And Quaker State, of course, Pepsi. And of course, R.J. Reynolds. Boy, I tell you what, I got to thank them for this $1 million. I'm blown away. I should have never won that race, Jerry. I really shouldn't have, and I didn't think I was going to, but I did tell you earlier in the week, if it came down that last lap, I'm going to do whatever it takes to get back there.
What about the last lap? They're stacking the money behind you, so you got plenty of time. They got a Megan to stack in behind you on the car. That final lap, you and Jeff Burton, it got awfully close.
You know, my car picked up a really, really bad push. I thought maybe I could hold them off the three laps, but all of a sudden, when I come down to take the white flag, the right front just went away on me. I didn't know if I had a fender rubbing or what. And I saw him coming, and I blocked him. He hit me in the rear bumper, and I was just glad that I didn't spin. I kept it going, and that slowed his momentum down enough to where I could block him. I'm sure he's not happy, but Jeff, $1 million. Come on, buddy. What you expect me to do, man?
Hey, we heard your car owner tell you on that last restart, Rick Hendrick from home. He said, I believe, Jeff, I believe you can do it.
Was that Rick? I don't think that was Rick. I think that was just a voice to sound like Rick. But I hope he's watching. We love you, buddy. And, man, this is so awesome. And you don't know this yet, but Ray Everham and I talked earlier. 100,000 of this is going to go to the Bone Marrow Foundation for the Leukemia Society. We got Jonathan here in our pit today. He needs a bone marrow transplant. We're looking for a match. And the least we can do is at least give $100,000 to the Bone Marrow Foundation. Thank you.
All right, Jeff Gordon, the American dream. He had a million-dollar date, and for the second time in the 13-year history of the Winston Million, here at the track Too Tough to Tame, a driver collects it. What a job by Jeff Gordon.
He led 116 laps here this afternoon, and he led the one most important, the final one. And so Jeff Gordon writes his name in the history books as the second driver to ever win the Winston Million. And it came in 1997 at the end. Here's the check presentation to Jeff.
Randy, I got to thank R.J. Reynolds and Winston Tobacco and for everything that they do for Winston Cup Racing. And I tell you, I'm gonna have to have it come back more often. And you're going to have to come to every race from now on. Give away some more money. But this is just an incredible, unbelievable day. I really never thought anybody could ever win this million again.
let alone three Southern 500s in a row. Oh, that is awesome. I want to thank Mountain Dew and Pepsi for putting this great event on. And I tell you what, I'm just, oh my, I can't believe it. I can't believe it.
Let's go back to the race.
Here are the points now as we head for Richmond. Jeff Gordon on top by 25. Musgrave, the top 10. We'll be in Richmond next Saturday night. Coming up next, the Molson Indy Vancouver. And a possibility of Alex Zanardi winning the title for 1997. Jeff Gordon has won $1 million here by winning his third straight Southern 500 at Darlington, South Carolina. Thanks for joining us. This has been a presentation of ESPN, the worldwide leader in sports.